Factors of agriculture. Human factors. Sam and Mzee had a busy week being introduced to agriculture and seeing the old farm. They have arrived home and are sitting at the lake having a Fanta.
How is the soda, Sam?
Great. Orange is my favorite. It gets rid of my thirst with all the traveling and learning.
Well, what exactly did you learn, Sam?
Heaps. There are so many branches of agriculture that range from crop production, livestock rearing, and agricultural engineering. Within the actual farming, there are different systems, and with each system come methods, such as mixed farming and nomadic pastoralism. Agriculture entails so much. No wonder it is a very large part of our economy and livelihood.
Good. Now you have considered all the humans behind the crop and cattle.
What do you mean?
I take that as a no then. Sam?
Yes, Mzee?
There are so many factors that influence agriculture. There are humans that need to work the earth, pest and biotic factors that help or destroy crops, the weather and climate which varies, and the earth, the soil and dirt itself matters so much. You can't grow anything unless it is from the ground up.
My head is dizzy.
Let's think about how us humans matter in this process. I stated earlier that the best farmers are educated ones. I always speak the truth.
Yeah, so you say.
Other human factors that influence farming include technology, health, economy, transport, communication, market forces, government policy, cultural and religious beliefs.
I guess you want to talk about each one of them.
Listen, farming takes a lot of different subject knowledge and technical know-how. You need mathematics to make accurate measurements, science to make proper observations dealing with signs of diseases, and needed treatment, as well as accounting to keep proper records.
What about technology?
You need to be able to work with technology to keep your machinery functioning, which cut costs and maximizes yield, which means more money.
I like the idea of cutting costs and making more money.
Of course you do, but this depends on the factors of the economy, government policy, and the market forces.
The what? Who? When?
Relax. Economy entails items such as liberalization of trade, which may lead to cheaply imported goods flooding our market. This forces agricultural products to drop in price due to competition. This affects farmers negatively because they may lose work to these imports.
Then how do we compete?
Farmers need to be educated on agriculture to be able to produce a better and cost-effective products. We also need to focus on diversification, which is growing a wide variety of products, giving us an edge to compete favorably in the world market.
How is this all decided? Is there a poll of farmers?
No. The national government decides how the laws govern production, marketing, and distribution of agricultural products. There are laws that can be enacted to help the farmer compete, such as heavy taxes on imports, subsidizing growing of locally produced commodities, and quality control policies.
So, with all these policies, the government could help build a want for local grown products.
Correct. By increasing the demand, it can help us sell Kenya's supply, which is economics. You are picking up pretty quick, Sam, and I like it.
Trying to keep it all in motion.
Good. Now, how did you know what I wanted to talk about next?
What are you trying to communicate?
Exactly, Sam. Transportation, or moving, and communication side of agriculture, which is very important because we need to find the fastest and cheapest way to get our flowers to Europe.
If there is poor communication between a farmer and a truck driver, he could deliver milk to the factory late.
Yes.
Which leads to loss of time and money. Well, That's okay because I don't drink a lot of milk.
That is your own personal preference. Anyway, what is interesting to think about is if a whole community was dependent on milk products for their babies. This is a cultural practice that affects agriculture. Some religions don't eat pork due to their beliefs.
How? I love pork. Without pork, how would I be healthy?
Yes, Sam, but each human is different. You must remember that. And health is the last factor I would like to discuss.
Eat more pork.
Shh. Farming is physical labor, and it is important humans take care of themselves properly to be able to do the work. If unhealthy, it leads to a shortage of farm labor, increased cost of living due to medical bills, low food supply as criminal activities increase, and a focus on controlling diseases rather than investing in agriculture. You know what I mean?
I think so. That is a lot to think about. Good thing humans are the only factors to worry about.
Were you not listening? You are a pest. Wait 1 second.
Oh, come on.